Hello friends! Welcome to this channel. In this video, we will overview glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency. So let's begin. Red blood cells are protected from the increased oxidative stress present in its environment through NADPH and reduced form of glutathione, both of which are produced in pentose phosphate pathway. In the first step of this pathway, enzyme G6PD help convert glucose-6-phosphate to 6-phosphogluconolactone. This reaction also results in reduction of nicotinamide adenine dinucleotide phosphate, or NADP, to NADPH. NADPH is important for converting oxidized glutathione back to its reduced form. This reduced glutathione protects red blood cells from oxidative damage by oxidants such as superoxide anion and hydrogen peroxide. When G6PD levels are low, it will result in low levels of NADPH and consequently low levels of reduced form of glutathione. This results in increased susceptibility of red cells to oxidative stress and hemolysis. Glucose-6-phosphate dehydrogenase deficiency is the commonest red blood cell enzyme defect. It is more common in people from the Mediterranean and Africa. It is inherited in an X-linked recessive fashion, therefore commonly present in males. In females, if heterozygous, it may present as neonatal jaundice or rarely in adult life, only when females are homozygous for the defect. Features of the disease. Neonatal jaundice is often seen. Intravascular hemolysis, which is precipitated by infections, many drugs and some foods like fava beans. Let's stop proceeding further and see which drugs are implicated in precipitating a hemolytic crisis. Drugs causing hemolysis in G6PD deficiency include antimalarials like primaquine, chloroquine, quinine and pyrimethamine. Analgesics such as aspirin and phenacetin. Antibiotics like ciprofloxacin, sulfonamides and nitrofurantoin. And other drugs include dapsone, quinidine, probenecid, vitamin K, and other sulfa group drugs like sulfasalazine, sulfonylureas. On the other hand, antibiotics that are thought to be safe in G6PD deficiency include penicillins, cephalosporins, macrolides, tetracyclines, and trimethoprim. Getting back to our features. Pigment gallstones are common in many patients. Splenomegaly may also be present. On peripheral blood film with supravital staining, Heinz bodies in red cells, which represent precipitated denatured hemoglobin, are seen. Bite and blister cells may also be seen on blood films. Bite cells, as the name indicate, are the red cells from which portion with precipitated hemoglobin is bitten off by the splenic macrophages. Diagnosis. Diagnosis is made by using G6PD enzyme assay. Enzyme levels should be checked around 3 months after an acute episode of hemolysis. This is because, during an acute episode, RBCs with the most severely reduced G6PD activity will have hemolyzed, and the newly formed reticulocytes have higher enzyme levels. Therefore, enzyme assay at this time will give a falsely negative normal G6PD levels. Management. First step in hemolytic crisis due to G6PD deficiency is to stop the offending drugs or foods. Also, treat any underlying infection. Blood transfusions will be needed in severe cases. And this is it for this video. Thanks for watching. Please give your feedback and comments, share this video with your colleagues, and consider subscribing to this channel to get notifications about latest videos.